Bathurst Touring Car Masters on the warm-up lap. Don't forget, top 10 shootout and a fight for pole in the Super Cheap Auto Bathurst 1000 at 4:30 live Australian Eastern Standard Time from here at Mount Panorama. The guy next to me, Alan Grice, you know about snagging a pole at Mount Panorama, do you not?
Yeah, I have had a couple of those. It's very pleasant.
You did try to start from the escape road one year in a shootout, do I recall? That didn't catch on.
No, but it worked that day. You were able, actually, to get through the corner more quickly.
Got you a pretty good run on the pit straight. Here's the points in Touring Car Masters. John Bauer leads from Jim Richards and Andrew Medici. This is the penultimate round. They've got another round at Sandown a little later on in the year, but John Bauer is in the box seat to win this title. And this is really the category that reminds us of yesteryear, but under the bonnet of some of these things, it's not yesteryear, it's very modern.
Oh, there's a lot of modern engineering in these things. You know, the cost of components have to be made in a lot of instances for engines. Makes them quite expensive, but they're very reliable, and that's great.
And that's what they've done with this category. It's not strictly historic racing. It's kind of historic slash modern. Nigel Benson will be on board in the HQ Monaro. He's second in Class B coming into this one. Massive field of cars, great variety. We should point out too, Glenn Seaton not starting. The Falcon had a drama yesterday. John Bauer, Andrew Medici pulling up to the front row of the grid.
Sure, which places? Yep.
It's Brad Tilley, Eddie Albanese on row two. There's one of the Porsches with Greg Keane. They probably need a bit of help. They might need a turbo whacked on the back of that thing to keep up.
Oh, yeah. Every chance they can doze off, I think.
John Bauer on pole. He's a winning man. He's won 14 races from 20 this year. You'd think he'd share.
He's a show-off. And he loves it.
He has been really the four man in the car they call Mustang Sally. Great field of cars, great variety. We've got Monaros and Camaros, Falcons, Chargers. Greg Crick's been able to push the Mopar back car further up the grid. Porsches and Mustangs and HQs. Final race of the weekend for Touring Car Masters. We'll wind back the clock just a few decades. Remember how it used to be and how it still is at Mount Panorama. Bauer and Medici, Tilley and Albanese. Plenty of Fords at the front. Can the GM products work their way through? Away, seven laps ahead. More slow start from Greg Crick. They all had to avoid him.
They did well.
Turn one, all three in the one. Bauer and Medici side by side. We've made it through, but where's JB going? Three wide on the run-up mountain, straight. This is tight. Oh, yes. Medici hangs on to it. Oh, that could be bad.
Sheep Station there. Very much for Sheep Station.
Whole countries were on the line then. Somehow they got away with it. Eddie Albanese, who won race two of the weekend. Look at the background, though. Oh, that's close. Adam Bressington down the inside in the Camaro. It's wild and willing.
There's a lot of blue mist out there.
Albanese leads Tilley, Medici, Bow. Then Bressington, Keith Kosuke. There's Jimmy Richards in that AMC Javelin trying to chip his way up through the order. Starting from the 10. You can tell it's the last race of the weekend, though, can't you?
It certainly is.
Across the top. Fans on top of Mount Panorama love to see these cars.
Don't they?
Rewind the clock, and it was Pete Gagan and Bob Jane and Norm Beachy and Alan Moffat.
Yeah, Mark is there.
Look at this guy's getting into it. Not tempted to get out there.
Well, at the moment, JB's sitting back and wondering what's going on. He's in the middle of a barroom brawl.
On board with Greg Crick, he's in the charger that this car's been developing along nicely. Taking it up to the established Falcons and Camaros and Mustangs and the like. Eddie Albanese's car smoking. It's been doing that all weekend, but
yeah,
it seems to be going.
It must be well, sir, Josh.
That was tight. Brett Yulden almost out the fence. And this long run down Conrod straight for the first time. Now, we were talking off air before. What was your first Bathurst 1000 car?
A Fiat 124 Sport Coupe.
I think it'd be still on the grid right about now in this race.
I could run up the hill faster than
I tell you what, Brad Tilley's running faster down the hill because the Green Falcon has gone to the lead. Medici, Bauer, Adam Bressington. SLR 5000 to run there at Tony Edwards. Who was the first guy to race one of them?
Yeah, I was.
Yeah, you were. It was a couple of years ago.
It was actually an SL 5000, yes. Bowie's sitting back there with his mouth open. He, I don't think he wants to go into the public bar. He's going to have it looking down the inside, but no.
But he covers that off in the 95 Camaro. But a little touch with the wall. Replay the start here, and it was all pretty even. Greg Crick was really slowing the charge of it. It was three wide into turn one, and they kept it going up Mountain Straight.
Yep.
Brad Tilley's getting away, though, now.
That's got some horsepower.
This is a little tight. Oh, this is even tighter. This is going to keep going.
Oh, the boys are in play.
You love it, don't you? The climb back up the top of the mountain. You've got to come here this weekend and the 50th year celebration. I can't believe how many people are here. In all your years of coming here, have you ever seen a crowd like this?
No, and it's Saturday. And it was almost a race crowd yesterday.
Yeah, quite phenomenal. Let's have a look. This is the replay. Three wide up Mountain Straight, bow to the right, Abonisa in the middle, Medici on the left.
Oh, excuse me.
That's spicy. Have a look at the bottoming out here on this replay too. The Falcon hardtop was scraping the bitumen on the run up the hill.
I'd say Crockett could have taught him to do that.
He
went to my driving school, he did. Yeah, he learned a lot of good things there.
Did he pass?
He was a... Yeah, I suppose he passed, yeah.
Oh, look out! Oh, the Abonisa gets a tap on the way through. I wouldn't mind betting the Falcon has expired just at the wrong point.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Whoa! He gets cleaned up!
There'll be a safety car, I'm sure.
Brett Yuldon went to make a move on another car, but didn't know he was there. And clipped him on the way through on the run to Forest Salvo. Yellow flags will be on display. He wants to get out of here as soon as he can, but everybody knows there's a drama. And this is Greg Crick.
If he'd had an ejection seat, he would have gone for it.
The charge has stopped as well, so dropping like flies on this second lap. Brad Tilley still leads the way.
It's got to be a safety car. Not low, he's got that out of the road.
Plenty of damage to the Sydney's Gavin Bullis and Tony Evans.
It's picnic time in the turf.
The Porsches will be looking good if they keep dropping out like this. What on earth is going on?
Oh,
this
they're
one?
Just having a ball. They are having a ball.
Tilley leading, Medici next, then John Bow. Adam Bressington's fourth in that blue Camaro. Jimmy Richards up to sixth. Here's the replay. And I'd say the Falcons expired just there.
Just there.
Not Medici's fault.
No. Definitely not.
And then watch for the green Monaro of Brett Yuldon. He goes to make a move here on Mark King. Oh, there's a car there. Wham!
I'd say, yeah, John. Oh, and they just did it themselves.
That's where he ends up.
They missed the party up the top, so they thought they'd have one halfway down.
Brad Tilley, he's got a party going. This big Falcon is just charging.
When all that was going on, John Bow would have had eyes like dinner
plates. Oh, but it's gone at the cutting.
Now, this will be interesting.
Now, how on earth is he going to turn this thing around? There's nowhere to do a three-point turn.
No, not with a car that long.
Uh-oh, someone else is going around. Oh, I heard tyres screeching, but no one did. Medici just set the fastest lap of the race, and he's got... There's no one there to tell him when there's a gap in the traffic.
No, either. And he's followed up with the slowest lap of the race.
Finish this one yet? Wait and watch as the whole field approaches.
Yes. It just got in the marbles with that rear right tyre. No grip.
We saw an accident earlier in the Dunlop series where young Aaron Russell ended up in the wall and Medici's ended up in the same place. It's all stuck.
John Bow only needs one more car to expire or spin and he's hit the lead without passing anyone.
Jim Richards here is up to fifth. He's been chipping his way through. This is an AMC Javelin. I don't think we've ever seen a Javelin at Bathurst before until now. It's a work of art, though. Anything Jimmy does, he does it properly.
Oh, it's a beautiful looking thing.
Love hearing these things. They're on the rev limiter at the end of Conrod Straight. Now, this is... Oh, that's Brett Yuldon. Next lap around, nearly having another crash. We haven't even gone halfway, you know.
This is the best fun I've had all day.
This is not a Bathurst 1000. I was struggling to do Bathurst 100.
Look at this. Jimmy's through to what? Fourth, I think.
Yeah, up to fourth. Fastest man on the road. In the Shannon's Javelin. out front, though. JB's just stalking his prey.
Yeah, he just waiting for the action to happen right in front of him.
Bressington now is third in that Camaro. That's the next Steve Mason championship-winning car. Tony Edwards has had engine dramas in that Tirana this weekend. He's up to seventh, which is a good run. Gavin Bullis, former champ, is eighth. Not good news, though, for Chris Collins, bringing the four-door Falcon back into pit lane, so he drops out of the top 10. We often get asked, Gricey, through the V8 Supercars website, where are they now, a lot of the former drivers? What's filling up your time? What are you up to these days?
Oh, it's amazing how you find how to fill your weekend. I'm actually selling our own type of beer, which keeps me busy.
Who would have thought?
Oh, well, look at the water coming out of that.
That might need a bit to top it up.
That's not Black Diamond beer, that's water.
It's inspired. This is Tony Edwards. Have a look at this. Left front,
have a crack.
There.
Yeah.
Was
good
like
stuff.
Was it like that in 74?
Oh, he's only got one off the deck. That Falcon's looking strong. Barry's got that look about him.
He's just doing what he needs to do. He's got a good lead in the championship. He's actually placed this car for sale.
Barry, has he?
Yeah,
really?
I've got a funny feeling, though, that whoever buys it might end up with a driver in it already.
I thought he took it home and used to put it in the big bed every night, didn't he?
These two have stripped away. Jimmy Richards, though, is the fastest man on the road.
Just a bit far back, maybe.
Yeah, big gap, 5 seconds back to the leader.
JB will have picked the place he's going to pass, and he'll probably wait for another lap or so.
It's not going to be here, though, because that green Falcon has got way too much straight in there.
It's a jet, yeah. It's a jet.
Not flat through the chase.
And Barry picks him up on the brakes.
Yeah, Mustang's put on the stoppers. And all that margin that he just got, he's lost.
Yes.
End of Conrod. What do you think? In the day, no chase.
It's been absolute fun. The Falcon's starting to lose tyres. Starting to lose tyres.
Bowers just hunting. They're in the 25s. Jim Richards, 223.36.
It's not all over for Jim.
It's coming on strong. 3.5 seconds to find and 3 laps to find it in. He's just in the back of the shot there. Tell me, mate. You got a tip for tomorrow? Who's going to win this 50th year celebration race?
Well, can you tell me what the weather's going to do?
I don't think anyone ever can here, can they?
No. We've seen 100 degrees and we've seen snow. The same day, in a different year.
Give me a tip. Who do you reckon? Who's looking good? Stevie Richards and Mark Winterbottom, they're up there.
Yeah, it's hard to go past Triple A, isn't it?
Yeah, they are pretty dominant. They've been pretty strong, of course, Will. Decide pole very soon in the top 10 shootout. What about your old Bob, the Holden Racing team that you snagged a win with in 1990?
Couldn't find it. I think Tom Walkinshaw has whipped it on a plane back to or a ship back to England. I don't know where it is.
These two are really at it. Bow, though, in fact, they're going to call this one a couple of laps short. So this one, in fact, is going to be the last lap. So if Jimmy Richards was planning on using 3 laps, he's only got one to get it done, and he's probably a bit too far back.
Same with John Bauer, because across the top of the mountain, it should be strong for his car.
Off the top of the hill for the final time with the Touring Car Masters, we'll have the Utes and the Porsche Carrera Cup cars back on track in the morning before the start of the 50th year celebration race for the Super Cheap Auto Bathurst 1000. Richards looking. Not quite. Close. Eddie Albanese's four minutes to park on the exit of Forrest's elbow. And the rundown Conrod for the final time. Gricey, the current V8 supercar formula, unbelievably competitive. Could you have ever imagined, for all the years that you raced Group C and Group A, that it would be so absolutely tough as it is now?
Now, it is highly competitive. There's no doubt about that. And you can see here, Jimmy's having a big crack. And he's be
got
third.
It.
Yeah. JB hasn't given up. Look at the thought, the power of that Falcon, though. It's got some.
And he's going to cover it because he knows where JB will try to get by. So the final race of Touring Car Masters for the weekend will be a win.
Try and cross him underneath.
It'll be a win for Ford, but which one? It'll be the Falcon in the end.
Falcon.
The margin's 0.3 seconds. John Bauer second. And Jimmy Richards comes home strong. The 7-time Bathurst 1000 winner finishes in third.
Don't you just love that horsepower when you've got that little bit of an edge? He drove very well, notwithstanding, he drove very well, but boy, you can be skillful in a straight line.
It's all about the V8s in Touring Car Masters. Thank you, Gricey. Great to catch up with you. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. Keith Kasulke, fifth from Gavin Bullis. Mark King, Tony Edwards, Bill Pye, and Steve Mason rounded out the top 10.